Hello students, welcome back to Digital Learning DCE. Myself Dr. Manjula, working as Assistant Professor of Botany. In today's session, let us study about red rot of sugarcane, its symptoms, disease cycle, control measures and the pathogen which is going to cause the red rot disease in sugarcane. Let me begin with introduction. Red rot is a very serious disease of sugarcane plant which was first described in Java by Wendt in 1893 as red smut. In 1906, Butler reported the disease symptoms in several cane varieties growing in India and renamed this disease as red rot. It occurs in tropical and subtropical regions of the world where sugarcane is cultivated extensively. This disease is going to damage the sugarcane crop, as a result of which reducing the crop stands and also by reducing the sucrose content of the cane juice. Here we can observe the sugarcane field with where the infected sugarcane with a red rot disease. Here we can see the red color stripes or patches developed on the leaf surface and also in the stem region. Then coming to host and pathogen of red rot disease. Host is Saccharum officinarum, which is commonly called as sugarcane, and the pathogen which is going to cause the red rot disease is a fungus called Colletotrichum falciatum, where the perfect stage of this fungus has been described in Ascomycetes as glomerella. The mycelium is intracellular in nature, which is profusely branched with septate hyphae, which contains characteristic oil droplets. The hyphae closely intertwine together to form a small compact structure known as stroma under the host epidermis. Here we can observe the shriveled stem of sugarcane which is infected by the pathogen. So as a result of pathogen infection, we can also observe the symptom on leaf surface. Red lesions are developed at midrib region and also in the foliar region. So these are the spores or conidia of a fungus Colletotrichum falciatum. The fungus reproduce asexually by the formation of spores called conidia, which are developed in special fruiting body called acerulae. Here we can observe the black dot-like structures, which are nothing but the fruiting bodies of the fungi called acerulae. From this acerulae, a special type of erect hyphae are going to be developed. These are referred as conidiophores, which are usually aseptate. They are intermingled with a septate air-like structure called setae, and these aseptate conidiophores, on their tip, they are going to cut down single conidia which are of moon shape. This conidium develops at the tip of each conidiophore. They are hyaline in nature and they are crescent shaped. Crescent means half moon shape with two point dents. Either they are sickle shaped, provided with an oil drop in the center. The conidia germinate by producing 1 to 4 germ tubes to form the new mycelia of the fungus. Here we can observe the conidia which cut down a single conidiophore, which are going to cut down single crescent shaped conidia with oil drops. Then coming to the symptoms of sugarcane red rot, that the disease symptoms appear on all aerial parts like stem, leaf sheath. Everywhere we can observe the symptom of the disease, which is going to develop after rainy season, where the early symptoms of the disease are yellowing and drooping as a result of infection by the pathogen. The stem of the sugarcane appear yellowing in color and it start drooping off the upper leaves near the tip. As the disease advanced, there is a blood-red lesions with dark margins developed on the midrib region as well as on the foliar region. As severity of the disease increases, when the skin splits lengthwise and subsequently red-colored blotches appear along the length of the cane, which emit a particular smell of alcohol fermentation. Here we can observe the various symptoms of red rot of sugarcane, where it is primarily after the rainy season, the yellowing of the leaves appear, and as a result of that, they start drooping down. In severe condition, there is a red color patches or lesions developed on the surface of the leaves and also in the split cane. The reddening appears mainly in the vascular region. As the fungus attacks, it is going to suppress the nutrient uptake, mineral nutrient and water uptake in the vascular region. Ultimately, the cane becomes dull in appearance and it start get rotting, and it shrink at the internodal region. In later conditions, the center of the lesions becomes straw colored. This is the conidial stage, when the fungus start to produce the spores, then it becomes straw colored with the formation of asexual fruiting bodies called acervulae. Acervulae are nothing but the asexual fruiting bodies from which the conidia are going to be born. The lesions become covered with powdery mass of conidia, which later spreads the disease late in the season. This acervulae appear as a dark, velvety, dot-like structure in the shriveled areas and also in the internode region of the sugarcane stem, near the nodes of diseased canes. Coming to disease cycle and spread of the disease, seed sets from the diseased cane are the chief means of pathogen survival, and they are going to reoccur the disease year after year. And the second one is ratoon crops. Ratoon crops are nothing but from the remnant of the already existed cane, which is left for getting the new crop, that is said to be ratoon crop. It also serves as a source of perennation and inoculum multiplication. Once the pathogen establishes inside the plant, the secondary infection occurs by conidia. Here we can observe the disease cycle. This is the sugarcane plant infected with the pathogen Colletotrichum falciatum. As a result of well establishment of the pathogen inside the host tissue, it is going to form a asexual fruiting body called acervulae or acervulus, from which the conidiophore arises and give rise to a crescent shaped or moon shaped conidia with pointed end, and it carried or disseminated by wind from one place to another place. When it fall on the another fresh host plant, it start infecting the new plant tissue, and this disease cycle repeats year after year. The fungus is capable of growing and producing acervulae in the soil, hence the survival of the mycelium spreads the disease to new plant. The high humidity, waterlogging conditions, lack of proper cultural operations and continuous cultivation of the same variety year after year are the main factors responsible for the development of disease. Conidia, after they get detached from the conidiophore, which are the asexual spores, they disseminate it through the agency of wind and also by means of insects. When they reaching the surface of healthy plant, they start to germinate immediately in the moisture retained in the closed leaf sheets, and they penetrate into the host at nodal region where there is a wound. Here we can observe, this is the seed set of sugarcane, where it is used for planting. Since if it is carries the pathogen or inoculum, when it is used for planting, the infection starts from the plant itself, and it is going to produce the established the mycelium inside the host, and it is form the conidia, which are half moon shaped and which have the capacity to reinfect the new plant or nearby plant again and again during unfavorable season. This pathogen is reside in the soil as a chlamydospore. This chlamydospore also germinate to form new inoculum, new pathogen, hyphae. Coming to control measures, it includes field sanitation like collection and burning of diseased plants. That is one important measure to prevent the buildup of sorts of inoculum in the soil. Inoculum, use of healthy and disease resistant seed set can also control the disease. Long-term rotation of the crops can minimize the soil-borne infection, since chlamydospores are going to viable in the soil. The crop rotation can minimize the soil-borne infection. And cultural practices like ratooning results in multiplication of the disease, hence we must discourage this practice. We have to use healthy seed set for planting instead of ratoon cropping. So use of disease resistant varieties like CO846, 952, 975 and some other BO22 are some of the resistant varieties of sugarcane which are able to resist the pathogen. It is also one of the most effective method of controlling the disease. Then next controlling measure includes treatment of seed set with organomercurials like Areton, which helps in eradication of superficial inoculum. Besides, treatment of sets in 0.5% Bavistin solution also reduce the disease incidence. Coming to summary, I'm going to recall the current session with following points, where red rot is very serious disease of sugarcane, occurs in tropical and subtropical regions of the world, and this is caused by a fungus, Colitotrichum falciatum, where the fungus reproduce asexually by forming a special type of spores called conidia, developed inside a fruiting body called acervuli, where the conidiophores are usually aseptate and unbranched, which are going to produce a single half moon shaped conidia, which develops at the tip of the conidiophore, and the disease symptom appear on all the aerial parts of the plant like leaf, leaf sheath, stem, including yellowing and drooping up of the upper leaves with dark red lesions on the leaf surface and also in the midrib of the stem, and the cane splits lengthwise containing powdery mass of conidia. The seed sets from diseased canes and rotten crops are the chief means of pathogen survival. Once the pathogen establishes, the secondary spread occurs through conidia, which get dispersed through wind. The conidia get detached and dispersed through the agency of wind, water, and also by means of insects. So the disease control includes field sanitation, crop rotation, use of healthy and disease resistant seed set, and also by treating the seed set with certain fungicides like Areton and Bavistin. With this, I'm going to sum up, conclude the session. For further details about the current topic, you can refer the following references. Thank you.